In this video, you'll learn how to use Assessment Pro in Gnowbe. But first, you need to learn what Assessment Pro is. Assessment Pro allows a curator to design programs that can be reviewed and assessed by another individual. This individual could be the learner's manager, supervisor, teacher, or an external authority on the subject on which the candidate is being trained on. For any assessments that use open-ended questions, or assessments that require anything other than a multiple choice question, it is recommended to use Assessment Pro. Do note that Assessment Pro is a premium feature available to Gnowbe premium subscribers. If you wish to subscribe to Assessment Pro, then please contact your Gnowbe representative, or your plan may already include Assessment Pro. Also, if you are using Assessment Pro in a program, do note that you won't be able to add regular assessments to that program. Now let's see what a program using Assessment Pro is like from the learner's side. In this example, the whole assessment will be in one session, and each action will be one question. And it is recommended to do so in Gnowbe, as to not confuse the learner which is a scored question or not. After you are done with the program, you will reach the end, where a pop-up will appear. Click on Submit Assessments. And at the top, you will see a button to submit your program. Your answers will be locked, and you won't be able to make any changes once you submit it. Click on Submit. That's it for the learner side. Now on the evaluator side, after the learner submits the program, the evaluator will receive an email saying that a learner has asked for your evaluation. Click on View and Evaluate. Here, the evaluator will be able to rate each question on a scale of 1 to 5. And the evaluator can also leave some feedback if they wish to. You can see that there are different kinds of input from the learner. This one is a multiple choice question. This one is an open-ended question. Here, they have submitted a video. And here is a file submission. Now let's rate all these. Currently, I cannot give a score to this video submission because the rating is not on for this question. Now you can leave some final feedback. Now that this is done, you will see that there is instant feedback on the learner side. Here the learner can click on View Feedback and see the evaluator's feedback. Here the final score is calculated from the percentage of ratings that the learner got. Also note that on top of the page, it will say if you passed or failed. To fully use Assessment Pro and understand it, you must first understand the three different roles. First is the learner. This is the participant who is attempting the program and providing responses. The learner needs to be a registered user on Gnowbe and will contribute to a set license. Second is the sponsor. This is an optional role that most of the time isn't used. This is the person that the learner asks for an endorsement. This could be a senior colleague or any other team member who can vouch for the learner's identity or work. A sponsor does not need to be a registered user on Gnowbe, and they cannot edit any responses, only view them. Lastly, there's the evaluator. This is the person who scores the learner's responses. The evaluators will determine whether the learner passes or fails the assessment. The evaluator does not need to be a registered user on Gnowbe, and there can be multiple evaluators for each individual assignment. To further understand these roles, here is a simple analogy. The learner is a student who sits for the paper. The sponsor is the exam invigilator or proctor who verifies that the student is the correct person who sits for the exam and does the paper. And the evaluator is the assessor who marks the exam paper. Now, you will learn how to set up Assessment Pro as a curator. First, go to Edit Mode and make sure that you have actions that require user input. After, go to Program Settings, scroll down to Assessment Pro. Turn it on. If you have a premium plan, this will be unlocked. If you don't, this will be locked. If you click on the Assessment Basic, you can determine what the passing grade is for the learner to pass the program. Then, after you have turned on Assessment Pro, go to your assessments. Now you will see three different options in each user input section. The first is rate participants' answers. The evaluator will see the learner's answers and will be able to rate or grade them. The second is view participants' answers. The evaluator will see the learner's answers but will not be able to rate or grade them. And lastly, the third is hide participants' answers. The evaluator will not see the learner's response for this action. We'll keep it on rate. And even on this one, which is a photo or video submission, you can have all these options. Now, for the final step, you will have to go to Gnowbe dashboard to set up the roles. Once you're in Gnowbe dashboard, go to Groups and select the group in which your program is in. Once you're in the group, click on Programs and add the program. If Assessment Pro is turned on, your program will be included here. Click on Add. From here, you will be able to set the deadline for which this program is available. You can choose to skip manual sponsorship or not, depending on if you want a sponsor role. For our purposes, we will skip manual sponsorship. Once you have added it, it will pop up here. To set each individual's roles, click on the program, and you will be able to see every user who is enrolled in this program. Set the roles. Go to Assessment Pro tab, and here you will have to add evaluators to each learner manually. Once you click on Add Evaluator, there will be two modes for the assessment passing. The first is aggregated score. By choosing this, Gnowbe will take the average score provided by all the evaluators. And if that score is higher than the passing grade, the learner will pass the assignment. Percent successful evaluation means the passing will be based on a majority vote, where, for example, if there are three evaluators and two evaluators give a passing score to learner, the learner will pass, and vice versa. To add an evaluator, input their name and email. I will notify them when this individual leaves the program. Through this, you can add multiple evaluators as well. That's it. Good luck.